This is Falcon Launch Control, 1 hour, 31 minutes, 43 seconds into the flight of Jason-3. Joining us here at the Public Affairs Console is Tim Dunn, who was our NASA Launch Manager during the countdown this morning for the Launch Services Program. And Tim, we've been following this flight, and it appears by all accounts that the count went well and the flight went well, but maybe you can give us some background, how things have gone.
Be glad to do that, George. So let me first off say today is a thrilling day for NASA, in particular for the NASA Launch Services Program. Getting to today has been a long journey, as you can imagine. First time we've had a NASA Launch Services Program mission on a Falcon. The Falcon 1.1, we spent a tremendous amount of time getting it to the level of certification so that we could do what we just did this morning here on the Central California coast. So with that, I can tell you that it was a very active countdown. We got in early this morning and tried to get things going a little bit sooner than the timeline because we felt we might have some issues to work. And we kind of worked an issue with getting the helium pressurization from the ground supply onto the bottles on the vehicle. It was mostly how the ground supply helium is managed at Slick 4. So that caused us to do a little bit of some workaround actions that we resolved through our anomaly resolution process. And that drove some other changes that our engineering team, working alongside SpaceX's engineering team, just did a tremendous job. I just can't say enough about how well the two teams, the NASA team and the SpaceX engineering team, worked together to resolve several anomalies throughout the countdown.
How did the flight look?
So we only had a 30-second window today, and we only had 2 days on the range before we needed to stand down for another range customer here and then try again later should we not have launched. So as you can imagine, we are very excited to have launched today. The flight itself, we've just done a little bit of data review, what we call a quick look data review, and first stage and second stage performance looks very nominal. Could not have asked for a better day. The first stage burn looked beautiful. The first burn of the second stage put us into the perfect parking orbit. And then about 42 minutes later, after that, we came up over Africa where we did our insertion burn into the operational orbit for the Jason-3 spacecraft. That was a very short burn, about a 5.5 or 6 second burn. That went very well as likewise. And then we had a nominal spacecraft separation.
So by all accounts, Falcon 9 has come across for delivering Jason-3 on time, on orbit.
On time, on orbit, yes. The final orbit numbers looked right on the money. So for the spacecraft, looked very good. We could confirm that the solar array deployment did go well. We're still waiting for another pass where we come across Africa, and the spacecraft will downlink its full state of health data to the that ground station in Fairbanks. So we should know more about the full state of health of the spacecraft when that occurs.
Well, Tim, thank you very much, and congratulations on a very happy, successful launch. And I know that we had a lot of additional issues to work to get to this point, and it all worked.
Oh, thank you so much, George. It's a tremendous amount of work to get to a day like today, but it's nice when you can celebrate your successes.
We're now at 1 hour, 35 minutes, 55 seconds into the flight of Jason-3. This is Falcon Launch Control.